Now, every week, viewers vote for your choice online in our Friday Lightning Round poll. And this week, the DOJ FOIA rule change won with 47% of the vote. We're back with the panel. The DOJ, Department of Justice FOIA rule, is Freedom of Information Request. And the rule change said that if someone asks about a program that's classified, rather than just say, we can't give you that information, that the government can just say, it doesn't exist, essentially misleading the people who filed the FOIA request. Is this justifiable or troubling?
I think if lying is going to be your policy, it should be a secret policy. It's always bad politics on the part of the government to admit that they're trying to pull one over on you, especially, by the way, now when people's trust in government is so low, I think they even trust reporters more.
Not to mention Congress, Charles.
Well, I guess I'd find it both justifiable and troubling. In other words, I can imagine circumstances when this might be necessary to do, but I don't think we should be happy about the fact that that might be the case.
That's a stated policy. John?
Yeah, I'm sort of with David on this. I think it's a bizarre policy change politically. I mean, just suicidally stupid politically. But I don't know that it's necessary. I can see there are cases where it might be necessary. But the existing practice has been to say we can neither confirm nor deny the existence of something, which was code to judges to say, hey, back off on this kind of thing. Why you need to say we can now lie about it just strikes me as weird.
Right. You could just say we cannot confirm any programs that are classified, and therefore we can't say anything.
They're providing cover to employees who fear prosecution, presumably, under the previous situation, that they would tell a lie and might fear getting prosecuted for that.
Okay, now the Super Committee. Super Committee has another hearing next Tuesday. This week, CBO Director Elmendorf went in and said, now look, guys, I know your deadline's not until right before Thanksgiving, but we need several weeks to figure out whatever you come up with and actually give it a score. So, you know, we'd like to get it in early November. Well, November starts next Tuesday, and they're not quite close. And this week, we had sort of opening rounds, if you will, from the Democrats and the Republicans. Even some Democrats didn't support the one from their party because it had some entitlement changes. And Republicans rejected tax increases that were in the Democratic proposal. So where are we in all this, David? And is this a good sign that the two sides have come out with their opening bids, or a bad sign?
I think on the one hand, it's not a bad sign that they managed to keep everything quiet for so long. We didn't hear a lot of private sniping. This one's mad at that one. They're yelling at each other. They each came out then in public with a competing plan, and that's to be expected because, you know, Democrats and Republicans look at this differently. I'll just say this. We're gonna spend a lot of ink and a lot of videotape over the next month trying to figure out where these guys are going, and every day there's going to be a new story, but it all comes down to taxes. Republicans are never, ever going to vote for a tax increase. And so the only way you get a deal done is if they find another way to score revenue, Democrats sign on, and then you put that before the House and the Senate. Otherwise, it's going to sequestration because Republicans will not commit political suicide, particularly given the political and economic environment we're in.
And sequestration, we should explain, is automatic cuts of $1.2 trillion, which is the target here. Automatic cuts, half in domestic discretionary spending and half in defense, and everybody seems to want to avoid that.
Yes, they do. I sort of feel like there might be one way forward in this recalculation of the consumer price index, the inflation factor that's used to raise benefits in the entitlement programs and also to adjust tax brackets. And that might be one way possibly to get a little more, sneak a little more revenue in. But I sort of feel that we're right back where we started from last summer at this point, and that argues for some kind of a bill coming out that is not going to meet the target, and then you would have sequestration on whatever's left over.
Now, Jonah, one of the things, it seems to me that the Republican position has been somewhat mischaracterized in some of the reporting. It's not that Republicans are against any change in revenues, but they want to use any change in revenues for tax reform, not to just increase taxes in order to meet a $1.2 trillion target.
Right. I think the possibility is that we'll have something very big, which includes major tax reform, or nothing at all. I mean, remember, everyone talks about sequestration as if it's like opening the seventh seal of the apocalypse and it has to happen. It doesn't have to happen. John McCain has already said maybe we won't do anything. Maybe they'll just change the law and we'll invite a whole bunch of downgrades from credit ratings and the rest rather than do the cuts. It could be really ugly.
Yeah, it could be ugly. Yeah. Well, let's get to the World Series. Not that you guys can possibly know what will happen, but we had an exciting game last night. The Rangers were ahead, I have to say, from Fort Worth, Texas, so, you know. the Rangers were ahead. In the bottom of the ninth, the Cardinals managed to tie up the game. It goes to extra innings, and in the bottom of the 11th, they win. Do they have momentum, or have they used up all their luck? David.
Jim, I married into a Texas family, but St. Louis is going to win. And I watched that game, and I think when you're one strike away from a World Series title, your first one twice, and then you lose the game and the next game's at home, I just don't know if Texas can recover.
Charles.
St. Louis is a team of destiny. They overcame La Russa's mistakes in the previous game. I think they're going all the way.
John. There was a big joke on Twitter today that Mitt Romney came out four square for the St. Louis Rangers. But if I have to pick, I think it's such a Hollywood story, it's the Cardinals.
Okay, that's it for the panel. Stay tuned for a video analysis of the administration's mortgage relief plan.